Hi everybody, this is Brian Sanders again from the Sanders Hypnosis Center, and I'm here with Sam today, and I'd like to demonstrate for you a couple of inductions that we like to use in our office. The first one we're going to talk about is the Elman induction, and many of you know who Dave Elman is, and it's a wonderful induction. It's fast, it only takes about 3 or 4 minutes, and it works on about 95% of the people, and it gets them very deep in hypnosis very fast. All right, so Sam, may I have your permission to hypnotize you?
Absolutely.
Wonderful. Okay, take a nice deep breath all the way in. Then all the way out. That's right. One more deep breath all the way in. And all the way out. With your eyelids already closed down, just direct your attention to your eyes and your eyelids and the muscles around your eyes, and just direct your attention to the sound of my voice. That's right. And the sound of my voice just helps you to go deeper and deeper, relax. Now, allow your eyelids to relax completely. Relax your eyes and your eyelids and the muscles around your eyes completely to the point where they just don't want to work. You are completely in control. And when you're satisfied that your eyelids are so relaxed that they just don't want to work, just give them a quick little check. Wonderful. Stop checking and allow that feeling of relaxation that's in your eyelids right now to wash over your entire body from the top of your head all the way down, down, down to the very tips of your toes, like a warm, warm blanket of relaxation. Just letting go. Wonderful. Now in just a moment, I'm going to ask you to open your eyes and close them down, and when you do, I would like for you to go 10 times deeper relaxed, 10 times deeper, 10 times safer, 10 times more secure. And opening now, closing down now, all the way down, going much, much deeper. Wonderful. Now in just a moment, we're going to do that again. This time when you do it, we'd like for you to double your relaxation, going twice as deep, twice as safe, twice as calm, twice as secure. And opening now, closing down, all the way down now. Wonderful. Just letting go. Just letting go. Going twice as deeply relaxed. Now we're going to do that one more time. This time when you do, we'll like for you to go much, much deeper relaxed. And opening now and closing down all the way down. Going much, much deeper relaxed. That's right. Now you're doing a wonderful job with the physical aspect of relaxation. We have another kind of relaxation we like to call mental relaxation, and here's how we're going to achieve that. In just a moment, Sam, I'm going to ask you to count out loud from 100 on down, slowly and deliberately. With every number you count down, allow yourself to go deeper and deeper relaxed. And sooner than later, perhaps by the time you get to 95 or even sooner, those numbers will get smaller and smaller and smaller and further and further away. So they become so small and so tiny that you can just push them all over the edge. The lights will go out and they'll be gone. You can make it happen. You can want it to happen. Let me demonstrate for you. 100. 99. 98. And so forth. Now it's your turn to begin counting out loud from 100 right now. Deeper and relaxed.
99.
Just letting go.
98.
Now see them getting smaller and smaller.
96.
Further and further away.
96.
Smaller and smaller and further away.
95.
And the deeper you go, the better you feel.
95.
Just let them go now. Just push them away. We don't need them now. Just let them go. Are they gone? Wonderful. I'm going to be saying some words, and they're directed to the folks on the camera. And these words that I say will not distract you in any way, shape, or form. In fact, it will only help you to go deeper and deeper relaxed. And if you wish to listen to the words that I say, it's perfectly fine. They will only help you to go deeper and deeper relaxed. Now, we have achieved a nice, wonderful state of relaxation with Sam. And she's obviously in a wonderful, nice state of relaxation. Her eyes have a very nice flutter. She has a very nice color tone in her face, and she's very, very relaxed. throughout the process, I was watching her breathing as I was counting. I was counting along with her breathing. And I'm about to do a deepener in just a second. And I'm going to place my hand on her shoulder. And when I do so, I'll be counting down backwards. But as I do so, I'm going to be watching her breathing. As she exhales, I'm going to be pressing down slightly on her shoulder. Now, Sam, you've achieved a nice, wonderful working state of relaxation. We have another level of relaxation that's even deeper than this, a level that we like to call the basement of our relaxation. And here's how we're going to achieve that. In just a moment, I'm going to place my hand on your shoulder. I noticed that I told her ahead of time that I'll be placing my hand on her shoulder so that it doesn't alarm her. So I'll be placing my hand on your shoulder, and I'm going to count down from 10 down to 0. With every number I count down, Sam, allow yourself to go profoundly deeper, relaxed. And here we go now, and 10. Notice that I'm pushing down with her breathing, and 9, just letting go. That's right. And 8, deeper and deeper. And 7, that's right. And 6, just letting go now. 5, the deeper you go, the better you feel. And 4, that's right. 3, just letting go. Deeper and deeper now. And 2. And 1. Deep, deep, deep relaxation. I'm going to pick up your arm now. Be loose and floppy now. Loose and limp and floppy. Wonderful. Loose and limp now. Just loose and limp. Wonderful. You're doing a wonderful job. Now, this deepener has worked absolutely wonderfully. Some of you may have noticed that I left the hand relaxation out of the Elman induction. But I already know how susceptible she is, and she goes very deeply into hypnosis. So I was able to leave that part out. What we're going to do now is run through a battery of Arons tests, and just to see how deep she is into hypnosis. So we're going to do the first one. We're going to do the eye closure. In just a moment, Sam, your eyelids are going to feel like they're glued tightly shut. They're going to feel like they're glued tightly shut. I'm going to count from 1 to 3. As I count from 1 to 3, they get tighter and tighter. And 1 is like they're stuck tight with crazy glue. 2, stuck even tighter. Lock down. 3, lock down tight. Lock tight. Try to open your eyes and find that you can. Try to open your eyes and find that you can. And stop trying. It's kind of funny, isn't it? It kind of makes you want to laugh. And stop trying. Relax. Go even deeper. Relax. Just letting go. Wonderful. And the deeper you go, the better you feel. Now we're going to go to Arons 2, and we're going to do some arm catalepsy here. Now, Sam, I'd like for you to extend your arm out right, lock it tight, lock it nice and tight, like a fist, lock it tight, even tighter and tighter, and lock it tighter, stiff and rigid, stiff and rigid, stiff and rigid, and 1, it's as if your elbows fuse to your arm. 2, it's like your shoulder is fused to your whole body. 3, it's like your arm is made from one solid piece of steel, and it gets tighter, and it gets tighter, and it gets tighter, and try to bend it and find that you can't. Try harder to bend it and find that you can't. Try to bend it and find that you can't. I'm going to snap my fingers, and it's going to just relax like jello and relax now, just letting go. Wonderful. A nice deep sigh of relief. Just letting go. And what's nice about these Arons tests is that they also serve as convincers for the client as well. And so once they get through one step, they also realize, wow, this is really great, this is really working for me, and we can go on to the next one. So next we're going to do, I'm not going to really say it because I don't want her to know what I'm talking about, but in just a moment, Sam, you're going to be feeling some pressure right here in your hand, right here. You're going to be feeling some pressure, and it's not going to bother you at all, but you're just going to be feeling some slight pressure. You just feel me working down here. It's not going to bother you whatsoever. Just feel some very slight pressure. That's not bothering you at all, is it? Just some very slight pressure. Wonderful. Very good. Now, Sam, in just a moment, I'm going to ask you to open your eyes, and when you do, you'll go even deeper into this wonderful state of relaxation. But you're going to look at the spot where I'm squeezing right now. Just tell me what you see. Good, and take a look at that. Right down here. Looks like I was pinching pretty hard right there. And you just feel some pressure?
Yeah.
Any pain?
No.
Okay. All right. Take a look at my hands and sleep. Let me go. Go even deeper, relax. Wonderful. And the deeper you go, the better you feel. Excellent. Excellent. Now we're going to go to amnesia. And what I'm going to do now is we're going to run through a series of numbers and have her erase just a couple of numbers. So now, Sam, I'm going to take away from your memory just the number 2. Just now, not the number 2. I like number 2. We're going to take away the number 4. We're going to take the number 4 away from your memory, but don't worry, we're going to put it back. But for right now, number 4 will just be completely eliminated from your memory. And you'll be counting as so. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and take a look at your hands. Open your eyes. Go deeper into hypnosis. Go ahead and start counting on your fingers, please, from left to right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Okay, that's kind of bizarre, isn't it? How many fingers do you have?
10.
Okay, let's count them again.
1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Doesn't really make any sense, does it? Were you born with 11 fingers? Is there something that you didn't tell me? Okay. Interesting. All right, and sleep. Go even deeper into hypnosis, just letting go completely, doing absolutely wonderful. And I like to put that number 4 right back into your memory. It's right back, right where we found it. And it's right back, right where we found it. Now we're going to move on. She's doing a wonderful job with these Arons tests, so we're going to move on to the next level. What we're going to do is we're going to do a positive hallucination. So, Sam, in just a moment, you're going to look in front of you, and you're going to see this most adorable puppy that you have ever seen. Such a cute puppy. You just want to take it home with you. It's such a beautiful, adorable little thing. 1, 2, 3, eyes wide open. And see that puppy? Tell me about it.
It's a
Yorkie. It's a Yorkie. Okay, what color is he?
Black.
Okay. How big is he? Show me with your hands up how big he is. Okay. Can you go pick him up? And bring him back to your chair? Wonderful. He loves you. He's so cute. Oh. I think he wants you to take him home. Wonderful. He's all yours. Look at my hands and sleep. Even deeper, relaxed. Wonderful. Now she did a wonderful job with the positive hallucination. We have one more step we want to go to. We want to have a negative hallucination. And basically that means that I'm going to tell her that she cannot see me. Even though I'll be sitting right here, I will be completely invisible to her. And that is a negative hallucination. So Sam, when I count to 3, your eyes will open wide and you'll be going even deeper into this wonderful state of relaxation we call hypnosis. And as you do, you're going to hear the sound of my voice, but you're going to wonder where I am. You cannot see me. And you're going to wonder exactly where I am. And you're going to be looking for me. And you will not be able to see me, but you'll be hearing my voice and you'll be finding that very odd, very unusual, particularly in light of the fact that it was just Halloween. 1, 2, 3, eyes wide open. Man, can you hear my voice, Sam? Okay. So, where am I? I must be around here somewhere. Maybe I could throw my voice over there. Or maybe I'm up there. It's kind of bizarre. Maybe I shrunk down, maybe I'm really tiny and really small. The interesting thing about a negative hallucination is that in order for her to not see me, part of her mind has to, in fact, see me in order for her to not see me. So that's pretty interesting. Gonna close your eyes down. Go even deeper, relaxed. Wonderful. And in the future, when you do open your eyes, you'll be able to see me just fine, just normally, naturally and normally. And I'm sorry, but you won't be able to take the dog home with you. The dog is now vanished and in cyberspace. Wonderful. And now we just ran through the whole battery of Arons tests, and she did a wonderful job with them. And at this point, I mean, she's so deeply in hypnosis right now. We could do a lot of interesting things as far as medical hypnosis is concerned. At this point, you know, she's feeling complete numbness. We could do surgery on her if we wanted to. Not that I have any intentions to do so, but this is a really great state for her to be in, and I know she's a great hypnotic subject, and that, you know, she's capable of doing wonderful things with her subconscious mind. Now we're going to do the emerging. When I get to the number 5, not any sooner, your eyes will go wide awake, feeling awake, alert, refreshed, and absolutely glad, and you feel so happy that you've had this experience here today, that you got to work with hypnosis and really understand what it can do for you and the powers of your wonderful subconscious mind. One, becoming more and more aware of your surroundings. Two, feeling the energy entering your body from the tips of your toes to the top of your head like waves of pure, fresh, clean energy. Three, feeling absolutely wonderful. Four, it's as if your eyeballs are being washed in a crystal clear mountain stream. Wiggling your toes, wiggling your fingers, and a deep breath all the way in, and big stretch, and 5, eyes wide open. See how good you feel. Welcome back, Sam.
Thank you.
So, can you tell our watchers a little bit about the experience that you had and how you felt, and maybe the feelings that you had going into hypnosis and while you were in hypnosis?
Going into hypnosis, I'm amazed at how fast that he can make that happen. Isn't it amazing? Within seconds, I'm just in a total different state of mind. It's an amazing feeling. I felt heaviness, but at the same time, lightness, and back and forth throughout the session. What else did you want to know?
I think...
what I was feeling?
You know... We went through a series of tests, and you know, we did the eye lock test, and you actually kind of giggled at the time.
I did, because I knew what was, I know what's going on, and I tried to, it really felt like my eyes were glued, my eyelids were glued to my face, like I could not open them.
Okay.
And it was just, it made me giggle, because I tried really, like, hard, like, wait, my eyes aren't opening. Like, what's going on here? It's amazing.
And that was really great. And you had also the arm lock.
Mm-hmm.
And did that kind of freak you out in that you couldn't bend your arm? Or
it didn't freak me out, but I was more just interested. You know, when you said, you know, you won't be able to bend your arm, like, I really felt like I couldn't move my arm. Like,
yeah.
It felt impossible to me.
Right.
And
right.
It's awesome.
And the next thing we did was we did the pinch test on you.
Mm-hmm.
To see if you could feel any pain. Did you feel any pain with that?
No. I did feel you touching my hand.
Right.
But when I looked at my hand and I noticed that there was actually a mark where you had been pinching me, I was like kind of taken back, like by surprise. Didn't feel like you were pinching me
right.
at all.
Right. You just felt pressure.
Yeah, I just
right.
felt that you were touching me and the pressure from your hand, but it didn't feel like you were pinching at all.
Good, wonderful. And I was really squeezing pretty hard there.
Were you?
Yeah. I mean, the mark's probably still there.
Really? A little bit.
Yeah. I don't know, you know, back in the old days they used to drive needles through the skin. I don't want to do that to you.
No, thank you.
And then we went on to the amnesia, where we did the forget the numbers, Had you lose the number?
The number was that was pretty cool.
Did you find it odd or bizarre that you were counting 11 fingers?
I was confused.
Yeah.
I was like looking at my fingers like, okay, I know well enough now that I have 10 fingers. I don't have 11.
Right.
But I was missing that extra number in there. So.
Yeah. And tell us about the Yorkie.
I was just sitting right there. I just imagined it and he was right there.
Mm-hmm.
Just cute as can be.
Awesome. And finally, we did the negative hallucination with me being invisible.
That was different.
Okay.
That was much different than any of the other other tests that we did.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like, because I could see you with my eyes, but I wasn't registering you
right.
in my mind.
Yeah.
It was weird.
Yeah.
It was weird. I don't know how else to describe it other than it being strange.
And she described it perfectly because, as I had mentioned earlier, in order for her to not see me, she has to be able to see me. Which I know sounds really confusing, but that's true. Part of her mind has to be able to see me in order for the other part of her mind to say, I'm invisible. So it's not like she doesn't see me, but she doesn't register that I'm there. So that's a negative hallucination. Well, that was great. You did a wonderful job.
Thank you,
Sam.
Thank you. You're awesome.
Oh, shucks.